So, question of the day. It's part three of the question that was asked last week. What is the abomination of the desolation?
Oh, yes. So we talked about how the abomination of desolation, spoken of by Daniel the prophet here in Matthew 24, Jesus speaks about it. When you see it stand in the holy place, Jesus said, then flee. We talked about the literal application of this. When the Romans brought their pagan gods into the holy place was the 2-mile exclusion zone around Jerusalem where no trade took place on the Sabbath day. It was called the holy place. When the Romans came and stood in that holy place, the Christians saw it as a sign to get out. The Romans withdrew, the Christians left, the Romans came back, they destroyed the city, no Christians died in the siege of Jerusalem. So that's the literal application. Then we looked at the more historical application, the prophetic application, where we find you've got this symbol of Antichrist standing in the place of Christ. And so you've got something that, you know, God's church, it belongs to God, but when Antichrist comes in and sits there as God, as himself, you've got it there in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse say 2 and 3, you've got this taking place. And so this becomes then a prophecy about the Antichrist. What we're going to look at this evening is a very symbolic aspect of this. Okay, so I want you to think back to the literal one. In the literal one, the Romans came and placed their pagan gods in a place where the Sabbath was supposed to be kept. And then they made a law. And that law was that any Sabbath keeper who entered that ground where the Sabbath was supposed to be kept would be killed. There was a death penalty for any Sabbath keeper who entered that particular spot. And it came to be that, you know, so many people were trying to escape, obviously, the city of Jerusalem, that Jerusalem was surrounded by crosses because they crucified every Sabbath keeper who came into that particular spot. And so this is interesting because think about this, Mon. The Romans who were there in the place where the Sabbath was supposed to be kept, what day were they keeping?
Sunday.
Sunday. That's right. So if you were a Sunday keeper, your life would be spared. If you were a Sabbath keeper, your life would be taken. And so this then brings us down to the end of time and indicates that the end of time, that the Sabbath will be a major issue at the end of time. And of course, some people have been, you know, calling up and asking, you know, lots of questions about, you know, say, for instance, like, well, how does this relate to the mark of the beast and all of these kind of things? Well, maybe you should send some questions in relationship to the mark of the beast. Because there's some really fascinating things that you could look at there in the symbolism of a death penalty for those who go into the area where the Sabbath is supposed to be kept, but Sunday has taken the place of the Sabbath and legislation being passed to that effect, which is most interesting, particularly in the world in which we live right now, where there are lots of Sunday laws being pushed by churches right around the world.
Very scary stuff, but also a message of hope, I suppose.
Absolutely.
If you have a question, give us a call here. Our number is 1-800-FAITH-FM. It's 1-800-324-843. We love fielding your questions. Send them all in to us.